The first electric guitar saw the light of day in New York City in 1941. A microphone in a wooden log. Its creator, Lester Pulfus, aka Les Paul, had learned everything about electricity, mechanics and sound, motors being music to his ears, working in his father's garage. In 1919, the year the Ford Model T arrived, his father would tell him, "It'll change the world," not knowing then that his son would one day change the world of music. Already a semi-professional guitar player at the age of 13, in 1934 he sought to amplify the sound of his guitar, which he felt was overwhelmed by the brass section of the radio orchestra he played in. In 1938, the owner of Epiphone, a rival of leading guitar maker Gibson, Mr. Strathopoulos, opened his workshop to the young Les Paul on Sundays. It took him 4 years to find the right composition, and after a further 2 years of testing, he was ready. Unfortunately, his mentor died. So Les then offered his invention to Gibson, who, while not believing in it initially, brought it to the market 10 years later. The Gibson Company had already made its name thanks to its many inventions. In 1896, Orville Gibson, a Kalamazoo-based string instrument maker, had developed the first mandolins inspired by A and F frame violin shapes, the first harp guitar, as well as the 10-string guitar. The small-scale factory was slowly transformed into the highly successful stringed instrument manufacturer and acquired its major competitor, Epiphone, in 1957. Gibson reached its peak with its famed acoustical guitars, adopted by the likes of Bob Dylan, and with the production of its electric guitars, including the mythical Les Paul model. By 1970, Gibson had 1,200 employees in the United States and sold up to 100,000 instruments a year. Irrespective of the brand names, the production of most electric guitars left America for Mexico. Gibson maintained its high-end custom manufacturing facility in Nashville, Tennessee, where their craftsmen and instrument makers cater to clients seeking custom-made instruments.
The Wizard of Waukesha, Mr. Les Paul.
Time for more to work.
I think Monday night is the greatest therapy for me. It gave me a reason to get out of bed. Between going to the bathroom and going to Mondays and playing at the Iridium, those are two greatest things that you can look forward to.
Somewhere there's music.
Can I see the guitar?
You play?
I've been known to.
That's cool. What's your name?
It's on your guitar.
Pioneer, inventor, rock and roll Hall of Famer, high school dropout, Grammy winner, Wizard of Waukesha, legend. Lester William Pulfus was born in Waukesha, Wisconsin in 1915. Like many Midwesterners, Les's history is rooted in beer and cars. His mother's family descended from the same people who brought us Blatt's beer and Stutz Bearcat automobiles. Like his ancestors, the man who would become Les Paul would make his own fast and intoxicating contribution to the world. By the time most of us were just graduating preschool, Lester was already showing signs of being a talented musician and inventor. By 13, Les was playing guitar and harmonica for the spare change of the country and jazz fans in his hometown. One particular music critic changed the course of Les Paul's life forever. He was playing in the parking lot of the local barbecue joint when the critic told him, "Your harmonica is fine, but your guitar is not loud enough."